Hi there, and welcome back for some more tips on SolidWorks. In our last video, we talked about the extrude feature in SolidWorks. Extruding is one of the most basic building blocks in SolidWorks. I use it all the time for converting 2D sketches into 3D objects. Extrude also has a negative corollary, the extrude cut. What extrude cut allows us to do is to remove material rather than add material to a part. Let's continue working on our little bracket here, just for demonstration purposes. Let's say I want to put a hole in the bracket. I can do that by opening a sketch on this surface, as I've already done, and then I'll just draw a circle. We'll dimension this guy. Maybe we'll make him 3/4 of an inch and 1 inch in each direction off of the edge here. All right. Now, when I come to my Feature Command Manager, you can see I have some options. I have the Extrude Boss Base. If I do that, SolidWorks says, oh, I think you want to add material to your part, and it gives you a preview. If instead I come to Extrude Cut, it says, hey, I think you want to remove material. It's hard to see in the preview, but let's just go ahead and accept the defaults and see what happens. What this does is it removes everything that I've sketched into the part. It's a negative extrusion. Okay, let's go back and edit that extrusion. Maybe I didn't want it to only be an inch, or I want to change the end condition. There's several ways to do that in SolidWorks. The first is I can click right on the part where that extrusion happened. And if you come up here, see this is the icon for Edit Feature. It's a feature icon with a hand on top of it, just like the Edit Sketch is this sketch icon with a hand on top of it. That is one way to edit that. The other way is to come over to the Feature Tree, click on the feature in the tree, and the same icon appears. So let's go ahead and edit that. That just takes me back to the settings of my original extrude cut. Let's explore some of those settings. First, we have our end condition, just like we had with a normal extrude. By default, it's set to blind. I can also change it to a bunch of different options. Through all cuts through the entire part, everything that's in the part. This is essentially an infinite end condition, meaning I'm going to cut this hole through everything that exists in the part. I can do up to next. This functions just like before, and it will go up to the next surface. I can go up to a particular surface. I can do an offset from a surface. So maybe I want this hole to come all the way up to, but not through, my back plane, and I want to leave 1/4 inch of material. All right. So what the offset from surface does is it will extrude that hole up to some distance from the part. This is really handy because right now if we look, okay, that it is a pretty deep part, and I can see there, I can change my viewing so I can see the hidden lines, and you can see now, look at that, it doesn't go all the way through, and I can see there's 1/4 inch of material. How did I change that view? Up here in the top of the graphics area, there's a display style box, and in that drop down I can switch between the different styles. Most of the time I end up working in the shaded with edges, because that makes it easy to select an edge or a surface. However, sometimes it's handy to use the wireframe view. Alright, let's go back to that shaded with edges, and now I'm going to modify or edit my original extrusion. And I can do that by either editing the sketch or editing the distance. Let's say I change and I want my part to be 6 inches. All right, so now I have a 6-inch part, and you'll notice when I switch to wireframe that because I did my extrude cut on the hole here, it still goes to within 1/4 inch of the end. So when I changed my base extrusion, it added depth to that hole to keep it 1/4 inch away from the end of the part. Very handy feature. You can also extrude cut thin features. Let's open up a new sketch on this side of the part, and I'm going to go ahead and draw a line. And I'm just going to draw a random line. It's way too wide there, but I'll leave it, and I'm just going to put a dimension from the top and say let's go ahead and make it 1/2 inch below the top of the part. Now, when I come up to Features, I can do an Extrude Cut. And check this out. It can do Extrude Cut through all, and if I just accept it, watch what happens. It lops off the top of that part. Let's go ahead and edit that. and see what other options we have. We can flip side to cut. What do you think is going to happen? Watch what happens. When I flip side to cut, now it cuts everything else off except for the top part. Let's go ahead and exit out of this, and I'm actually going to delete that so that we have our whole part back. And I'll delete that sketch. The other item I want to show you in doing an extrude cut is if I open up a new sketch plane on the top of that box and I draw a square. To be thorough, I'd want to fully dimension this, but for demonstration purposes, I just want to show you what happens when I do an extrude cut with that. Normally, I'm going to say through all, I could cut this out, and what would you expect to happen here? That's right, this is going to cut a square hole in my part all the way through. Okay. Now, let's go back and edit that. And if I flip the side to cut, check out what happens. Now I get a pillar. Okay. We'll uncheck that box, and we're back to just having the square hole. As we get into more advanced part modeling, paying attention to the different options in extruding and extrude cutting will become very, very important. That's it for now. We'll catch up with you next time.